Was it the perfect melt? With most of the snowpack gone, concerns for flooding ease in waterlogged communities across the heartland. Just warm enough, just dry enough, the flooding threat backs off. Good evening, I'm Rob McCartney.
And I'm Brandi Peterson. That threat is still there. Minor flooding now forecast this weekend near Hamburg, Iowa.
But upstream on Iowa's Nishnabotna River, guarded optimism in places like Harlan. KETV News Watch 7's Todd Andrews is live with our big story at 6. Todd?
Rob, relief mixed with concern is what authorities in Shelby County, Iowa, are feeling today as the snow and rain comes down. Though they're not seeing any flooding there, they're still watching water levels very closely. Like many southwest Iowa towns, Harlan sits in a valley. The West Nishnabotna River is part of Harlan's identity. It feeds the town's water supply, but in flood season, it presents a danger.
We monitor the weather 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
In the Shelby County Emergency Center, manager Bob Sievert stands watch. For weeks, he's been on guard. Winter snows left over 2 feet on the ground in his county, and the flood potential was high. On Thursday, though, Sievert started to relax.
We're very fortunate in the way that the snow's melting.
This winter's perfect storms have turned into a perfect melt.
The rivers have risen, but we don't see any ice in the rivers.
Water from melting snow is now working its way into the river at a pace that pleases those whose job it is to worry, and they do still worry.
Our concern at this time would be if we would have a severe thunderstorm or a prolonged period of rain.
4 to 6 inches of rain would blow the Nishnabotna right out of its banks, but for now, optimism is growing that the aftermath of the harsh winter will not be floods, but rather a spectacular planting season.
There seems to be a lot of standing water at this time. Fortunately, there's not a lot of frost in the ground, and a lot of that water will become subsoil moisture.
And again, a flood warning remains in place for Iowa's Fremont County, where the Nishnabotna is expected to crest Saturday 1 foot over its flood stage. Also, there are new flood warnings posted for the Missouri River from Nebraska City on south. Lowland flooding expected to start tomorrow. Reporting live, Todd Andrews, KETV News Watch 7.
Thank you, Todd. In Nebraska, there is still trouble in Dodge and Cumming counties. Highways 275 and 32 remain closed because of water over the roads. And during the night, ice jams caused flooding on Big Island Road south of Fremont, forcing a few residents there to evacuate. Some roads were blocked. Ditches were filled with flood water. A couple of people had to leave their homes.
Most of the people have been here for, 20 plus years. They're used to it. They know to move things to higher ground, and They usually, a lot of them will tell us when they know it's getting real bad. They have a lot of our phone numbers, and they'll call us and let us know when they're getting ready to leave, and then we know it's going to be really bad.
Latest reports show an ice jam remains on the Elkhorn River near West Point, but the river appears to be slowly receding.